In this screencast, we're going to look at three ways to simplify your code using refactoring in IntelliJ IDEA. I'm using version 2020.3 so that I can show you some of the changes and improvements as we go along. Simplifying your code has lots of advantages, including improving readability, tackling technical debt, and managing ever-changing requirements. The three ways to simplify your code are to extract and inline it, change the signature of a method, or rename something. The first way to simplify your code is to extract it. There are five types of extract refactorings that you can do in IntelliJ IDEA. You can extract methods, constants, fields, variables, and parameters. Let's start with the extract method. We have some logic in this method that isn't in keeping with the rest of the method, so let's extract it to a new one. In 2020.3, this process has been simplified. We can use Command, Option and M on macOS or Control, Alt and M on Windows and Linux to extract the method. We can give the new method a name and IntelliJ IDEA will replace the original logic with a call to our new method. You can get additional options for extract method by using the same shortcut again. Let's take a look at extract constant. Let's extract this number to a constant because the Earth always takes about 365 days to complete its rotation around the Sun. We can use Command, Option and C on macOS or Control, Alt and C on Windows and Linux to extract it to a constant. Let's call it number of days in a year. Now we get a new public static final constant at the start of our class. Next, let's look at extracting fields. The phrase "the weather is" repeated four times, so let's extract that to a field. We can use Command, Option and F on macOS or Control, Alt and F on Windows and Linux. I'd like to initialize this field in the field declaration, and I'm going to call it "the weather is". I also want to replace all four occurrences of it, and I'm going to leave the other default settings as they are. When I click OK, IntelliJ IDEA creates my new field at the top of my class. Next, let's look at extracting variables. Chained methods like this can be harder to understand, so let's refactor it into a separate variable using Command, Option and V on macOS or Control, Alt and V on Windows and Linux. I'm going to extract this to a variable and call it planet name length. Now we have a good local variable for this calculation. I'm also going to move that line up to the top of my method to further improve the readability. Our final extraction is extract parameter. Let's extract the UK country here so that we can pass that into the method. We can use Command, Option and P on macOS or Control, Alt and P on Windows and Linux. I'm going to call the parameter country. I'm going to also ask IntelliJ IDEA to replace all four occurrences of it and then select refactor. Our method signature has been updated to reflect the new parameter. The shortcuts for these types of refactorings have symmetry, which can help you to remember them. The shortcut for macOS is always Command and Option plus the first letter of the shortcut, and for Windows and Linux, it's always Control and Alt plus the first letter of the shortcut. For example, M for method. IntelliJ IDEA has just one shortcut that will inline any of the five types of refactoring that we've just spoken about. For example, we can use Command, Option and N on macOS or Control, Alt and N on Windows and Linux to inline the method that we've previously extracted. We often need to change the signature of a method. IntelliJ IDEA can help us with this process and the impact of the change on your wider codebase. Using our Planet class, let's refactor this constructor to take the season as an argument as well as the name. We can use Command and F6 on macOS or Control and F6 on Windows and Linux to change the signature of the method. We can then use Command and N on macOS or Alt and Insert on Windows and Linux to add a second string, and give it a default value, like summer. If we don't give it this default value, then anything that calls this method will need to be manually updated after the refactoring. IntelliJ IDEA will show you where the issues are, but in this case, I'm going to provide a default value and complete the refactoring. If we look back at our Planet Extractions class, we can see that the method signature has been updated here as well with the default value that we provided. The final type of refactoring that we're going to look at today that can help you to simplify your code is renaming. We frequently need to rename files or aspects of our code. I've added some new comments here to show you the new inlay hints that are available with renaming in 2020.3. Let's use Shift and F6 to rename our class to Planet Facts. When we press Tab, we can expand the new inlay hints. You can use Option on macOS or Alt on Windows and Linux to see the keyboard shortcuts. The first icon will change to blue if we select the checkbox for comments and strings. The second icon will change to blue if we select the checkbox for text occurrences. These options match exactly, including the case. I just want to find the instances in comments this time, so I'm going to select that checkbox only. When I press return twice, IntelliJ IDEA allows me to preview the refactor before I carry it out. I'm happy with those changes, so I'll click Do Refactor. I can see that my comment has been updated, as well as my class name. IntelliJ IDEA will make changes everywhere that uses that class name. For example, anything that calls that class and tests that test it. If you have properties files or XML files that use this text, IntelliJ IDEA may also show you those depending upon the options that you've selected. These are just some of the refactorings that you can do in IntelliJ IDEA that will help you to simplify your code. Thanks for watching.